Hello and welcome to another episode of Ahomiya Pakghar. Today I am going to cook for you mas tenga. Mas as in fish, tenga as in sour, fish in sour gravy. So this is a very simple recipe made by using just 8 ingredients and it takes me back to Assam right now. So let's have a quick look at the 8 ingredients. I have here around say 5 sleeve green chilies, 150 grams of rohu fish marinated with some haldi and namak, 3 tomatoes medium size diced, coriander leaves, methi seeds 1 teaspoon, haldi, namak. And last but not the least, I'm going to use some mustard oil for frying. But before we get into the cooking, here's a very important tip. The fish that I have used, which is rohu or roe mas, so it's a very important tip while cleaning this fish. Now this is everyone's favorite. We call it the patty of any fish. It's got a very thin membrane, a black membrane, which needs to be cleaned properly before we start consuming it. So here we go. First we're going to heat the kadhai. I'm going to use a cast iron ka kadhai. I'm going to switch on the gas now. Our oil is warm now. I'm going to add the fish to fry. Here goes the fish. Here goes the first piece. If you feel that the fish is fluttering a bit, put the lid on so that the oil doesn't dirty your clothes. Ensure that you don't fry the fish completely. It has to be half fried because we will have to let it cook again in the gravy later on. So we are going to slide it to the other side. Our fish is done. We'll take them out now. They look nice. Be careful at this point of time. So our fish has been fried. They look very crunchy. Ekdam yummy yummy to eat. And my kitchen is actually filled with the aroma of the fish. So in this dish, another important thing is that you do not need to add any more oil. In Assam, we call it masor telo te mas bhaja. So now I'm going to give a nice tarka or whatever you are brought on. I'm going to add some methi seeds. So here goes our methi seeds in the oil. Time to put the green chilies. So the methi and the chilies have been nicely little cooked. We'll add the tomatoes. Here goes the tomato. The color is beautiful, isn't it? Reddish, orange, green. But the aroma is also equally good. It's time to add some salt now because when we add salt, the tomato gets cooked easily because it melts away faster. Turmeric, a little more. We'll stir now. We will cover it for some time so that the tomato gets cooked in its own steam. We'll see how the tomato has been cooking away. They have almost kind of melted now. So we'll add some warm water now. Very important, please add warm water, around 1.5 cup. So we will again let it simmer for around say 10 to 15 minutes maximum. We'll put the lid now for a second stage of cooking. Let's see how our gravy has been cooking. They almost looks half cooked. See how they have melted so well. Time to add our fried fish now. Here we go. Remember, this gravy is not very light gravy, it is a little thick gravy. As we in Assam, we call it thuptupia. Thuptupia masor jul. yeah, let's dunk them in the gravy and simmer it for around say 5 minutes.
Smells yummy.
So we are going to add some coriander leaves for garnishing. It's time to add it. Let's go.
Yes.
Yummy. So it's a lazy afternoon and my yummy mas tenga is ready. What do I ask for? If you like today's recipe, hit like, share your comments, but do not forget to subscribe to India Food Network. Till then, this is Geetika Saikia telling you bye-bye.